day. When shall we meet again? And thunder, lightning, rain.
Hurly burly is done when the battle is lost and won.
That'll be here, the set of sun.
Here the place upon the heath.
There to meet with Macbeth.
Meow.
Come, Grey Malkin.
Who?
The paddock calls. Anon.
This is the sergeant, who, like a good and hearty soldier, fought for my captivity.
Hail, captivity.
It still hurts.
Hail, good friend. Oh. Tell the king about it.
The voice stood. Two swimmers clinging together, choked by their hearts.
The merciless MacDonald.
Worthy enough to be a rebel. For to that, the villainies of his nature do surround him. From the Western Isles, the currents and the galaglasses are supplied. Fortune of his damned quarrel, smiling like a rebel's whore. All's too weak for brave Macbeth, and well, he does deserve the name. Disdaining fortune with brandish steel, which smote with bloody execution like a valor's minion carved out of his passage, till he faced the slave, which he ne'er shook hands nor blade him farewell, till he unseamed him from the nave to the troops, fixed his head upon the battlements.
Once
the sun gins his reflection, shipwracking storms and direful thunder shook. So, come from what spring whence comfort seemed to come, discomfort swells. Mark, King of Scotland, mark no sooner justice had with valor armed, compelled these skipping kerns to trust in their heels. But from Norway lord, serving vantage. With furbished arms and the new supplies of men, we began a fresh assault.
Dismayed this number of captains, Macbeth and Banquo?
Yes, a sparrow's eagles, or the hare the lion. I say sooth, I must report they were. As cannons overcharged with double cracks. So they doubtly read doubled strokes upon the foe. Except they meant to bathe in reeking wounds. Or memorize another
What is that? Or memorize another Golgotha.
I cannot tell, but I am faint. My gasses cry for help.
So well thy words become thee as thy wounds. A smack of armor bolt. Go get them, sergeants. Who comes here?
Ah, the weather thinner for us.
What a haste look through his eyes. So should someone look that seems to speak things strange.
Right, Lennox.
God save the king!
Wait, game must die worthy thing.
Alright, so all I want to do is tell you about a victory. So, the Theta called them, the Norwegians, you know, they've been jerks, and we beat them, so it's great.
Oh, great happiness.
The king has given us tons of money, it's great.
Aha. 10,000. No longer fear that he of called our deceiver bosom interest.
Yep.
Go pronounce his present death, and with his former title, Cleet Macbeth.
Yep. Also need to point Angus first.
But he hath lost, noble Macbeth hath won.
Where hath that been, sister?
Hee hee!
Swine. Where thou, sisters?
A sailor's wife had peanuts on her lap. She munched and munched and munched. Give me, quoth I. brown thy witch, the rumped runyon cried. Her husband, Alippo gone. Master o' the tiger, and in a sieve, thither sail. A rat, like a rat without a tail. I'll do, and I'll do. I'll give thee a wind. Thou art kind, and I another. And I myself of all the other. What do we say here, there? And the very ports they blow, all the quarters that they know, I shipman's card, I drain him dry as hay, sleep shall neither night nor day hang upon his penthouse. Who writ this? I mean, wrote this, you know? He shall live, a man forbid, weary 7 nights, 9 times 9, shall he dwindle, peak and pine, through bark he cannot be lost, yet it shall be tempest-tossed? Look what I have. Show me. Wait, what? There's some notes here. Oh, yeah. Shoot. Let's get it. Where's it? There. I have a thumb. Show me. Here I have a pilot's thumb. Racked as homeward, he did come.
I'll take the Harold and you take the Lord. And I'll be in Scotland where my bonny uncle lives. I'll take the Harold and you take the Lord. I'll be in Scotland where my bonny uncle lives.
A drum, a drum! Macbeth doth come! Weird sisters, hand in hand,
pushing on the sea and land!
Thus to go about, thrice to thine, thrice to mine, thrice again to go up to nine! Peace! The charm's wound up.
So fair and foul a day I have not seen.
How far is it cold before it? Oh, what are these? So wild and so weird in their attire. They look not like the inhabitants of the earth in it. Or on it. Leave ye? Where are you at that man, my question? Beat it once laying our skinny finger upon their chubby lip. Ye should be women. And yet, your beards are beneath you from thinking that it's so.
Speak if you can. What are ye?
Hail to Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Glamis! Hail to Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Cawdor! Hail to Macbeth! Hail to thee! To be king hereafter!
Good sir. Why do you start and see the fair things which do sound so fair? Are you fantastical, or indeed which outwardly you show? A noble partner, you greet with present grace and great prediction, of noble having and of royal hope, yet he seems wrapped with all. To me you speak not. If you can, look in that seat of time, and say which grain will grow and which shall not. Then speak to me, who neither fears nor begs your favours nor your hate.
We're just gonna go turn off
because
we don't need it.
Hail!
Okay.
Hail! Lesser than Macbeth, but greater. Happier than Macbeth, yet not as happy. And get the hat! Get on.
Thou shalt get kings, but thou shalt be none.
Hail Macbeth and Banquo. Macbeth and Banquo, all hail.
Stay, you imperfect speakers, tell me more. By Sindel's death, I know I am Thane of Glamis, but how of Cawdor? The Thane of Cawdor still lives, a prosperous gentleman. And to be king stands not within the prospect of belief, no more than to be Thane of Cawdor. Say from whence you owe this strange intelligence, or why you stop us upon this eat. With your prophetic beliefs. Speak, I charge you!
Hey there.
The earth has bubbles, as the water has. Whither are they vanished? Oh!
Into the air, and it seems what Corporal melted vanished into the air.
Are these things here as you speak of that? Or have we eaten on the incinerary, which takes reason prisoner?
Your children shall be king.
You shall be king.
Thane of Cawdor too. Went it not so.
Ah, to the self same thing in the birds. Who's here?
Macbeth! The king heard of your success! Isn't that right, Angus?
Yeah, that's fine.
So, guess what are you gonna do? You're Thane of Cawdor now! What? No way! You're two things at once!
That's very cool, right, Angus?
Yeah, that's very cool.
I mean, yeah.
What kind of devil sweet priest?
The Thane of Cawdor lives. Why do you address me with toss robe?
Well, he lives, but after treason,
he's basically dead.
Yep, that's right, Angus. He's basically dead. I mean,
Thane of Cawdor and Thane of Glamis. The greatest is behind me. Thank you for your pains.
Oi! That was nothing!
Do you not hope that your children shall be kings, when the powers that gave me Thane of Cawdor promised no less to them?
Alas,
you're my
only friend. I think it's to the crown besides the Thane of Cawdor. But, this is strange. Oftentimes, the instruments of darkness tell us truths to win us to our harm. Win us with only trifles, and then betray us at deepest consequence. Cousins, a word, I pray.
Two truths I told as happy prologues to the swelling act of the imperial theme. I thank you, gentlemen. The supernatural soliciting can be not be ill, cannot be good. If ill, why hath it given me earnest of success, commencing the in truth? I am the Thane of Cawdor. If good, why do I yield at that suggestion, whose horrid image doth unfix my hair and make me my seated heart knock at my ribs against the use of nature? Present fears are less than horrible imaginings. My thought, whose murder yet is but fantastical, shakes so my single state of a man that functions in smothering in sunrise, and nothing is but what is not.
Look at our partner's wrapped with.
Why, chance will have me king, chance will crown me without master.
No honors come upon me, like a strange garment. Please not thin or mould, but with the aid of use.
Come what come may, time and the hour runs through the roughest day.
Macbeth, we wait upon your leisure.
Give me your favor, my dull brain walk rot with things forgotten. Kind gentlemen, your pain registered upon a leaf, so I turn to read every day. Let us towards the king! Think about what hath changed at one more time than at interim. Talk our hearts, freely our hearts, each to other.
Very gladly.
Till then, enough. Come, friends!
Ah, yes. This is wrong. That's important. The most important is Angus. Right, Angus. Yeah, I'm pretty important.
Yay! Angus! Angus!
Well, hello, people.
Is execution done on Cawdor?
At ease. They did not yet come back.
Sorry.
But I spoke with the one who did report.
Very frankly, he confessed his treason, implored your highness's pardon, and set forth a deep repentance. Nothing in his life became him like the leaving it. He died as one that had been studied in his death. To throw away the decent thing he owed.
I should have turned the light on out there. as 'twere a careless rifle.
There's no art to feign the mind's construction in the face. He was a gentleman on whom I built an absolute trust. Oh, worthiest cousin. The thing I mean, right to TV, the nail weighs heavy on me. Thou art so far before that even a swift swing of recompense is slow to overtake thee. Would thy hate's less deserved that the proportion both of thanks and payment might have been mine? Only this I have left to say. More as they do, then more than all can pay.
The services and duties we do in doing them pay themselves, Your Highness. That is to receive our duties, and our duties are to your throne. And the state children, and the servants. To the throne mostly, baby.
Oh, what is due by doing everything? Safe. Love.
Sorry.
Your Honor.
This is too gay for me.
Welcome hither.
Thank you.
I have begun to plant thee and will labour to make thee full and growing. I am noble Banquo, last no less deserve, nor should be known no less to have done so. I may enfold thee to my heart. And if I grow, the harvest is your own. My plenteous joys, wanting a fullness, seek to hide themselves in drops of sorrow. Sons, they and kinsmen, know that we will establish our estate upon our eldest Malcolm, who we name hereafter the Prince of Cumberland. His honour shall not accompany the vest only, but signs and ominous like stars shall shine from hence to Inverness, and bind us further to you.
The rest is labour which is not meant for you, so I'll be the hair bringing and make this make joyful to my wife the hearing of news. So I'll take my leave.
Hey, where are they, Cumberland?
The Prince of Cumberland. Now that is a step I must fall down or overleap, for it lies in my way. Stars, fire, let not light reach my deep and dark desire.
Charley was there, I remember.
The eyes won't get hand, yet let that be, which the eyes fear when it's done to see.
True worthy Manco, he is also valiant, and in his commendations I am fed. Let's after him, whose care has gone before to bid us welcome.
Oh, what is this? They met me in the day of success, and I have learned by the perfectest report, they have more in them than mortal knowledge. When I burned in desire to question them further, they made themselves air, into which they vanished. Whilst I stood wrapped in the wonder of it, came missives from the king, who all hailed me Thane of Cawdor, by which title, before, these weird sisters saluted me, and referred me to the coming on of time, with hail, king that shall be. This have I thought good to deliver thee, my dearest partner of greatness, that thou mightst not lose the deuce of rejoicing, by being ignorant of what greatness is promised thee. Lay it to thy heart, and farewell. Gladness thou art, and Cawdor, and shalt be what thou art promised, yet do I fear thy nature. It is to full o' the milk of human kindness to catch the nearest way. Thou wouldst be great, art not without ambition, but without the illness should attend it. What thou wouldst highly, that wouldst thou wholly. Wouldst not play false, and yet would strongly win. Thou'dst have, great Gladness, that which cries thus thou must do, if thou have it, and that which rather thou dost fear to do than wishest should be undone. Hie thee hither, that I make o'er my spirits in thine ear, and chastise with the valor of my tongue all that impedes thee from the golden round, which fate and metaphysical aid doth seem to have thee crowned withal. What is your tidings?
The king comes here tonight.
Thou art mad to say it. Is not thy master with him? Who, were so, would have informed for preparation.
So please ye, it is true. Our Thane comes here tonight. One of my fellows had the speed of him, who nearly dead for breath. Though his tidings would have made little more than his message.
Give him tending. He brings great news. The raven himself is hoarse that croaks the fatal entrance of Duncan under my battlements. Come, you spirits that ten unmortal thoughts, unsex me here, and fill me from the crown to the toe top full of direst cruelty. Make thick my blood, stop up the access and passage to remorse, that no compunctious visitings of nature shake my fell purpose, nor keep peace between the effect and it, and to my woman breast, and take my note for all, you murdering ministers, whatever in your cyber substance you be on your business trip. Come, quick on it, and fall me the tongue, smoke, a cup, that my pain now, see not the wound it makes, nor heaven keep you the blanket of the dust, to try hold you. Great Lammies, worthy Cotter, greater than both, by thee all hail hereafter, thy letters have transported me beyond this ignorant present, and I feel now the future in the instant to cry hold, hold.
My dearest love, Duncan comes here tonight.
And when goes hence?
As she purpose.
Oh, never shall sun that morrow see. Your face, my fame, is as a book where men may read strange matters. To beguile the time, look like the time. Bear welcome in your eye, your hand, your tongue. Look like the innocent flower, but be the serpent under't. He that's coming must be provided for, and you shall put this night's great business into my despatch, which shall to all our nights and days to come give solely sovereign sway and masterdom.
We'll talk further.
Only look up clear, to alter favor ever is to fear. Leave all the rest to me.
Oh, this castle hath a pleasant seat. Here, nimbly and sweetly recommends itself into your senses. See here, our honored hostess. Sometime the love that for us this is our trouble. Yet still we thank his love. Here, and I teach you how to ask God heal us for your pains, and thank us for your trouble.
All our service in every point twice done and then done double were poor and single business to contend against those honors deep and broad wherewith your majesty loads our house, for those of old, and the lay dignities he did up to them. We rest your hermits.
Where's the Thane of Caldor? We cursed him at the heels, now the purpose to be his purveyor here. But he rides well, and his noble love, sharp as his spur, hath helped into his home before us. Fair and noble hostess, we are your guests tonight.
Your servants ever have theirs, themselves and what is theirs, in compt, to make their audit at your highness' pleasure, still to return your own.
Give me your hand. Conduct me to my host. We love him greatly, and would express our graces further, be it okay with thee.
If it were done when 'tis done, when then 'twere, well, it were done quickly. If the assassination could trammel up the consequences and catch with his success, that but this blow might be the be-all and end-all here. But here upon this bank and shoal of time we'd jumped the life to come. But in these ceases we still have judgment here. That we but teach bloody instruments which being taught return to plague the inventor. This even-handed justice commends the ingredients of our poisoned chalice to our own lips. He's here in double trust, first as I am his king's man and his subject, strong both against the deed then as his host, who should against his murder shut the door, not bear the knife myself. Besides, this Duncan hath borne his faculties so meek, hath been so clear in his goal, great office, that his virtues will plead like angels
trumpet-tongued against the deep damnation of his thigh taking off, and pitied like a naked newborn baby, striding the blast or heaven's cherubim horsed upon the sightest curtis of the air shall blow the horrid deed in every eye that tears shall drown the wind. I have no spur to prick the sides of my intent, but only the vaulting ambition which overleaps itself and fall on the other.
He has almost sucked. Why have you left the chamber?
Hath he asked before?
No, you not he has.
We will proceed no farther in this business. He hath honored me of late, and I have bought golden opinions from all sorts of people, which would be worn now in the newest glass, not cast aside soon.
Beth was the hope drunk when you dressed yourself. Hath it slept since? And wakes it now, to look so green and pale at what it did so freely? From this time such by account I love. Art thou feared to be the same in thine own act and valor as thou art in desire? Wouldst thou have that which thou esteemest the ornament of life, and live a coward in thine own esteem, letting I dare not wait upon I would, like the poor cat I the adage?
Prithee, peace! How dare do all that may become a man, who dares do more is none.
If what beast was, then, that made you break this enterprise to me? When you durst do it, then you were a man, and, to be more than what you were, you would be so much more the man. Nor time nor place did then adhere, and yet you would make both. They have made themselves, and that their fitness now does unmake you. I have given suck, and know how tender 'tis to let the babe that milks me. I would, while it was smiling in my face, have plucked my nipple from his boneless gums, and dashed the brains out, had I so sworn as you have done to this.
If we shall fail.
But screw your courage to the sticking place, and we'll not fail. When Duncan is asleep, where to the rather shall his day's hard journey soundly invite him his two chamberlains will I wit wine and wassail so convince that memory, the warder of the brain, shall be a fume, and the receipt of reason a limbeck only, when in swinish sleep they're drenched. Nature's light as in the death, what cannot you and I perform upon the unguarded Duncan? What not put upon his spongy officers, who shall bear the guilt of our great quell?
Bring forth men children only, for thy undaunting mantle should compose nothing but malice. Will it not be received when we have mocked with blood those slippery two of his own chamber, and used their very daggers that they have done it?
But who dares receive it other, as we shall make our griefs and clamor roar upon his death?
How dare do all that may become a man, who dares do more is none.
I am settled, and bend up each corporal agent to this terrible feat. Away, and mock the time with fairest show, false face must hide what the false heart doth know.
How goes the night, boy?
Oh, moon's out. Not heard the clock yet.
And that goes down at 12.
Well, tis late.
Here, take my sword. There's husbandry in heaven. The candles are all out. Here, take thee this too. A heavy summons lies upon me like lead, and yet I would not sleep. Merciful powers, restrain the cursed thoughts that nature does give way to in repose. Here, give me my sword. Who's here?
A friend.
Ah, you naughty at the bed, sir. The king's abed, and he hath been an unusual pleasure. He has sent great largess to your offices. With this diamond he greets your wife withal. Giving her the name of most kind hostess, and shut up in the measurable content.
Being unprepared, wills became the servant to defect.
to a thought the free to rot.
Last night I dreamt of the weird sisters. To you they have showed some truth.
I think not of them, but we should talk about them later, if you would grant me that time.
At your kindest leisure.
If you are cleave to my consent, then when tist, it'll make honour for you.
Then I lose nothing in trying to augment it. But I shall keep my bosom enfranchised, and my head clear. I shall be counselled.
Yes. Well, tist, let's repose for a while.
Thanks, sir. I like to see you. Fleance.
Go bid thy mistress. When my drink is ready, she strike upon the bell. Go thee to bed.
Oi.
Is this the dagger of which I see before me? The handle towards my hand. Come. Let me clutch thee. I have thee not, and yet I see thee still. Art thou fatal vision, sensible to feeling? As to sight, or art thou?
We apologize for the inconvenience. We had planned to film the rest of this monologue, but due to technical and personnel issues, we are unable to complete it within the allotted time. We recognize that this is an important scene in the play, and we truly regret this oversight on our part.
Yep, what he said. And also, Jackson wasn't here to help us film it! Bastard.
Bastard.
Macbeth doth murder. Sleep no more. Glamis hath murdered sleep, and therefore Cawdor shall sleep no more. Macbeth shall sleep no more.
That which hath made them drunk hath made me bold. What hath quenched them hath given me fire.
Who?
Heart peace. It was the owl that shrieked. The fatal bellman, which gives the sternesty good night. He is about it. The doors are open, and the surfeited grooms do mock their charge with snorts. I half drug their possets. That death and nature do contend about them, whether they live or die.
Who's there? What ho!
Alack, I am afraid they have awaked, and 'tis not done. The attempt and not the deed confounds us. Hark! I laid their daggers ready, he could not miss them. had he not resembled my father as he slept, I had done my husband.
I have done the deed. Didst thou not hear a noise?
I heard the owl scream and the crickets cry. Did not you speak?
When?
Now.
As I descended?
I.
Hark! Who lies in the second chamber?
Donalbain.
This is a sorry sight.
A foolish thought to say a sorry sight.
Right.
One that laughed in his sleep and one did cry martyr.
That they did wake each other. I stood and heard them.
Also, they did say their prayers and dressed them asleep.
There are two lodged together.
One cried, God bless us. The other, amen. They watched me with my hangman hands, listening to their fear.
I could not say amen when the other said, God bless you.
Consider it not so deeply.
But why could I not say
these
amen?
These must not be thought after these ways, so it will make us mad.
Methought me heard a voice, sleep no more, Macduff does murder in sleep. The infinite sleep, sleep then, it's the riled slave of care. Oh, the death of each day's life, sore labor's bath, balm of hurt minds.
What do you mean?
Still it cried, sleep no more, Glamis thus murder sleep.
And therefore, Cawdor shall sleep no more.
Cawdor shall sleep no more.
Macbeth shall sleep no more.
Macbeth shall sleep no more.
You incompetent swine. Go get some water and wash this filthy hands. That's like the second rule of murder. The first being to never bring your murder weapon. Why, you didn't even do that right. Fine, just make it look like the groom did it, okay? Frame them before yourself. That's the third rule of murder.
Go back, I shall not. I'm too scared.
While you are a pussy. Give me the daggers. The sleeping and the dead are but as pictures. Tis the eye of childhood that fears a painted devil. If he do bleed, I'll gild the faces of the grooms withal, for it must seem their guilt.
Whence is that knocking? Oh, how is it with me? Every noise appalls me. What hands are here? They pluck out mine eyes. Will all great Neptune's ocean wash the blood clean from my hands? No, this is my hand. Rather, the multitude sees incarnates masking the green one's red.
Ah, my hands are of your... Wait a second, you're not in shot, get in shot.
My hands are of your color. But I shame to wear a heart, so what? I hear a knocking at the south entry. Retire we to our chamber. A little water clears us of this deed. How easy is it, then? Your constancy hath left you unattended. Hark! More knocking. Get on your nightgown. Blessed occasion called us, and showed us to be watchers. Be not lost so poorly in your thoughts.
Were best not to know myself. The knocking could wake Duncan. I would if I couldest.
And now for something completely different.
That's a knocking indeed. If I was a porter of the Hellgate, I'd... Someone about a key.
Knock, knock, knock. Who's there in the name of Beelzebub?
Here's a farmer that hides himself on the expectation of plenty.
There's no time. Just no one cares and kill yourself. Yeah.
napkin.
Knock, knock, knock. Who's there in the other devil's name? Fatal something or other. Riddles. Who cannot get into heaven. Come in the quiver, quaker, and we are. Knock, knock, knock! Who's there? You's there? Maya! Whatever this is, I'm gonna hit you with it! Ya wanker?
Here's an English tale or a French.
Come in, Taylor. Some hidden goose. Been knocking wanker. She's like, what? Who even are you? Am I in hell? No, this place is too cold for hell. Hell is fire and brimstone from what I heard, right? Mate, but it feels like it, because, you know, you're knocking when I'm trying to go to sleep, and I need another beer.
So am I, everlasting bonfire.
Anon, anon!
What's up so late, friend? There you went to bed last night.
What?
Drinks are. He's a great provoker of three things.
Oh, I know that means.
That's your line.
What line?
Fate, sir. We arrive into the second cock, and the drink is a great provoker.
I need to lay down.
You need to say your line.
What? Oi! You bastard, you'd stole my spot. What?
Say your line.
What's my line?
Fate, sir. With her carries into the second
please,
cock.
Sir,
and the drink is a great provoker of three things.
Cock.
What three things does it especially provoke?
Sleep, nose painting, and urine. It creates desire but takes away the performance. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, if you know what I mean.
You know what you mean.
Don't take it.
The drink gave thee the lie last night.
Yeah, drink gave me the lie last night. Last night in the ring, I was sitting there, I was about to get wrecked, and then, you know, I just
take
did a roll, dodged his tackle, and
take
I jumped on him.
Master, sir? Oh, our knocking has awaked him. Here he comes.
Good morrow, sir.
Good morrow, boss.
Is the king star?
Not yet.
He commanded me to call timely on him. Hey, I've almost slipped the error.
Yeah, I'll take you to him.
I know it is a joyful trouble to you. Yep, it is one.
Labour is not delighting, it's pain.
Not delighting in pain.
Here's the door.
I'll make some old to call, for it is my limited service.
I think, busy.
What was the king hint today?
He was appointed, sir.
The night has been all really? But really? Our chimneys were blown down, and as they say, lamentings heard in the air, strange screams of death, and prophesying with accents terrible of dire combustion, and through she's arrived, no hatch to the woeful time. The obscured bird clamoured the livelong night. Some say the earth was feverish and they say,
'twas a rough night.
My young remembrance cannot parallel a telepate.
Oh, Hunter, doesn't our heart cannot conceive nor name thee.
What is the matter?
Confusion now hath made its masterpiece. Most sacrilegious murder hath broke open that anointed temple and stole out thence the life of the building.
Oh, what do you mean, the life?
Mean you his majesty? Approach the chamber, destroy your sight. Destroy your sight with a new Gorgon. Oh, bid me speak not further.
Wake, wake! Ring the alarm bell! Murder and treason! Banquo, Malcolm! Donalbain! Awake! Shake off this downy sleep that's counterfeited and look on death itself! Oh! Rise up from your graves and walk like sprites of countenance this horror! Oh! Awake and look at great doom's image!
What is the business that such a hideous trumpet calls
To parley the sleepers of a house, speak, speak.
Oh, gentle lady, 'tis not for you to hear what I have to speak. The repetition of the words in the woman's ear with murder as it fell. Oh, Banquo, Banquo, our royal master's murdered!
Whoa, at last, what is in our house?
Oh, too cruel anywhere. Dear Raffi, pray thee contradict myself and say it is not so.
Had I died an hour before this instant, I would have lived a happy time. For from this instant, nothing serious about mortality. Renown and grace is dead. All is but toys.
What is amiss?
You are, and you don't know it.
Your royal father's murdered.
What?
By whom?
Those of his chamber, as it seemed, had done it. Their hands and faces were all badged with blood. So were their daggers, which unwiped we found upon their pillows. They stirred and were distracted. No man's life was to be trusted with them.
Yet I do repent them of my fury. I killed them.
Wherefore did ye so?
Who can be wise, amazed, temperate and furious? Loyal and neutral, in a moment? No man. The expedition, my violent love. Outrun the pauser, reason. Here lay Duncan. His silver skin laced with his golden blood. And his gashed stabs looked like a breach in nature. For ruin's wasteful entrance, there, the murderers. Steeped in the colors of their trade, their daggers. Unmannerly breached with gore, who could refrain? That had a heart to love, and in that heart. Courage to make's love known?
Don't meet him.
Oh, look to the lady.
Why should we hold our tongues? That they may take this argument for ours.
What should be spoken for? Our fates not yet concealed, hidden auger hole. They may rush and seize us.
No.
Let's away. Our tears are not yet brewed.
Nor our strong sorrow for this motion.
Look to the lady, and when we have our naked frailties hid, let us meet and question further this bloody piece of work. Ah, so that we may know it further. Fears and scruples shake us, and in the great hand of God I stand, and thence against this undivulged pretense I fight of treasonous malice. So do I.
So all! Let's briefly put on manly readiness and go to the hall.
Well contended.
What for you do, let's not consort with them. To show them an unfelt sorrow is an office, which the false man does easy. All to England.
To Ireland, aye. Our separated fortune shall keep us both safer. Where we are, there are daggers and men's smiles. Near in the blood. The nearer the bloody.
My father. The murderous shout.
Very kind man.
The murderous shout that shot hath not yet lightened. And our safest way is to avoid the aim. Therefore, to horse! And let us be dainty. Leave taken, but shift away. There is a theft which steals itself, and there is no money left.
Yeah.
Wrong room.